Hi, my name is Bobby Danford, and here at A1, we service our customers' needs by providing automotive services to their modern vehicle. 985 presents me with an opportunity to address my fellow businessmen and trading our services for their services. And again, my name is Bobby Danford here at A1, and we do look forward to doing business with you.
Well, Sheriff Daniel Edwards here at the River Fellowship Church. This is right across the street from Hammond High School. Had yet another prayer breakfast. You do this every month, and it's great that they're back.
It is great to be back again. This is our third month or so being back, and I thought it was well attended this morning. The weather certainly cooperated as well. That's always very helpful, but Brother Randy Ray and his daughter did a great job leading us in worship this morning.
One pall that hung over this event, including the prayer request, was the COVID-19 pandemic and just a large number of local residents who have either passed away recently or are seriously ill. And it just occurred to me that yesterday I was at North Oaks, 100% of the fatalities, the ICU patients, the seriously ill, 100% are unvaccinated. What do we say about this phenomenon?
Well, you know, it's something, Ken, you know, that our leaders have been saying. Dr. Fauci has been saying now for a while, CDC has been saying for a while, that the vaccination has been very effective, at least in preventing serious illnesses and certainly fatalities, even from the COVID variants that we know so far, including Delta. You're right. What struck me this morning when it got time for the prayer request was the number of names that got called out of people who have passed away in the last 2 weeks from the COVID Delta variant. I think it was five or six names that was given today. The number of people who are in the hospital right now in serious condition from the COVID. And then even after the prayer breakfast was over and I was talking to people, they actually gave me some other people who they know had passed away whose names were not called. And so let me just tell you, we went through this whole pandemic, for a year and a half. And I cannot remember a time when so many names had been given to me in such a short period of time. And so I'm suggesting to you that this Delta variant is real and that the surge is certainly here and it's probably ramping up. And there's going to be a lot more hospitalizations, including deaths, not just in Louisiana, all across the nation and all across the world. And my advice to people is, please go get your vaccinations. If you haven't, it's not too late to get them. I was vaccinated back in February. It's not that bad. I would encourage everyone who can get a vaccine to please go do so. You may just save your life, and guess what? You may save someone else's life by not passing on the virus to them as well.
I don't want to put you on the spot, but you mentioned that you spoke with your brother, the governor, yesterday, and he must be at his wit's end. Here in Louisiana, one of the least vaccinated states in the union, what can we do? The silver bullet is the vaccines. Another mask mandate or all the other options would be so minimal compared to the vaccines, which literally can end the problem and save all of these lives.
Well, we only spoke briefly about the COVID yesterday. We talked about other things, but I can just tell you, he certainly is a huge proponent of vaccinations. He's been preaching that. He believes it's time for other leaders to step up as well and tell people that it's okay to get vaccinations. Also, he believes it's time for other leaders to show that they've been vaccinated because without calling names, he knows quite well that some of them have. And yet when they get asked a question by a news reporter or by anyone else, have they been vaccinated? They won't say, yes, I have. No, I haven't. They say, I have a right not to answer the question. And certainly they do have that right not to answer the question. But a real leadership is about leading. And the truth of the matter is, we ought to be telling people right now that it's okay to be vaccinated. In fact, it's probably the thing to do. And if we as leaders have been vaccinated, we ought to speak to the public and say, yes, I've been vaccinated. And I encourage you to do the same, not sit there and say, well, I'm not going to answer that question. I think that person lacks a spine, and I think they lack leadership, and they ought not be in a leadership position if they can't answer that question.
Well, in the meantime, I don't know of a good transition to what else we are going to talk about, but the litter campaign in the parish with the sheriff's office, parish government, and other agencies working together, it really is bearing some fruit now.
Well, I think so as well, Ken. Yeah, I was elected sheriff, you know, elected over 17 years ago, been serving 17 years now, and I will tell you, one of the constants throughout that time is litter. People don't like it. It's an eyesore. They complain about it, and they always want to see something done about it, and I commend them for that. But when you get together and you work together and you start making some progress, they notice that as well, too, and you're right. We are getting compliments now by working with the parish, by having us a person who works regularly trying to go out and find the people who are responsible for these for littering and trying to pick up some of these areas that a lot of times you have these areas on the side of the road. They pop up as these temporary waste sites and go out and clean and eradicate those areas. The public does appreciate that, acknowledge that, and we are getting compliments for doing that along with parish government. So I think that is working, and we look forward to continuing that.
Well, you recently put Bert DiLiberto, a veteran police officer, in charge of the effort, and again, when it comes to enforcement, I think Bert's going to be pretty tough.
Well, he certainly knows what he's doing. There's no question about it. And again, so far we have gotten quite a few compliments on the job that he's doing. And I think the public seems to appreciate the way that that's working. And as long as they appreciate the way that's working and we're getting compliments, we're going to certainly keep doing it.
Well, here in Tangipahoa, let's just get an overview, 40,000 feet above the earth, looking down at crime here. We have had some unsolved murders of various jurisdictions in the parish, which is a great rarity here. But on the other hand, you know, crime, we're told as a whole, it's not up at all. What do you make of this? More gun violence, but less crime overall?
Well, there's certain, no question about it. Again, I haven't seen the most recent crime statistics during this year, but there's no doubt there's more gun violence. We have more guns being discharged this year, I think, than ever before. Not just in Tangipahoa Parish, this is nationwide. I can tell you, you know, I just got back from National Sheriff's Association in June. That was the report that was given there. I'll have a Louisiana Sheriff's Association next week. I guarantee you that's going to be a report we've given across the state of Louisiana as well. But as far as crime as a whole, you know, I don't believe right now that burglaries, for example, are going to be up at all, or certainly not significantly. I don't believe that armed robberies are going to be up at all, or certainly significantly, rapes and things like that. But gun violence, or people discharging guns, shooting one another, I do believe that crime category probably is up. It's a hard one to explain, and certainly that's a crime that as you know, is a serious crime, and it's one that we would love to get a handle on, and we would love to find a way to try to put a dent in that particular crime, not just here in Tangipahoa Parish, but across the state of Louisiana and across the nation as a whole.
You know, it appears as though perhaps some of the gang activity of young people, some of the youth crimes, they may have been brought under control.
Well, we're certainly trying. We're working very hard with the district attorney's office and some of the other jurisdictions to get that under control. And talking about, you know, the gun violence and gun crimes, let me just say, you know, that if the vote that was taken by the Senate yesterday in an attempt to override the governor's veto, you know, if that stands and they don't call any other votes and the governor's veto does not get overridden, I do believe that that's a good day for the state of Louisiana, because I think enough people now have guns that they don't need to be carrying concealed weapons without a permit, without any training whatsoever, and the safe handling of guns and learning how to shoot a gun and whatnot. And I do believe the governor's right when he says our concealed weapons permitting law now strikes the right balance, and just to allow anyone 21 years of age or older, you know, to carry a concealed weapon with no training, I do believe that was a careless, not well thought out bill, and I do believe the governor's veto was proper. And as a law enforcement official, speaking with my deputies and a number of sheriffs across the state, I had serious concerns. We had serious concerns about that, what that would do to the number of shootings already that are occurring. So I applaud the legislature so far for not having overridden that veto.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, you know, Ken, obviously with summers definitely out from a school standpoint, a lot of people on the waterways. By and large, that's going well. You know, I've gotten a lot of reports of people being irresponsible on the water, but we still have a ways to go, you know, before Labor Day gets here. I want to encourage people, when you're in a boat, you know, wear a life jacket. Certainly don't have alcohol. Don't be consuming alcohol while you're on or near the water, and certainly while you're driving a boat. And when you're swimming, always swim in groups of people. Always have someone with you and tell people where you're going. I think that's very, very important.
We want to have a strong start for this new school year. So we have a new and improved website for our families that is user-friendly. You can enroll your students within our school system. You can look at the student handbook. You can check any information about bus transportation. You'll find a back-to-school toolkit for families. Anything that you need to know to get your child back in school in August is in our toolkit. We want our families, our employees, and our students to all be able to connect with our new and improved website. It makes it easy for families, employees, and students to find the information that they need to have a strong start to the school year.